Dear students, in this video, we are going to see projection of solids. So, this is the first diagram in solids we are going to see. So, we have taken a hexagonal prism. So, this is the hexagonal prism you all know. So, it is the 3D model of hexagonal prism. So, this I have kept for your reference. So, it is the question, a hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm. So, the base side is 30 mm. Okay, so it will have 6 base sides. So all the sides are 30 mm. The axis length 60 mm. So the length of this particular hexagonal prism is 60 mm. So axis is nothing but an imaginary line that joins the center of this top face and the bottom face. Okay, so there is a line at the center of the hexagonal prism. So that is called as axis. Okay. So, if the axis length is 60 mm, so the total length of the hexagonal prism will be of 60 mm, okay. So, he is resting on HP on one of its base side. So, totally 6 base sides are there. So, it is going to rest on HP on any one of these sides, okay. Next, with its axis inclined 40 degree to HP. So, the axis, I have told what is axis. So, if the axis is inclined 40 degree to HP and if it is parallel to VP, so if it is inclined, if the axis is inclined to HP, so it will be parallel to VP, then what will be the projections? So, this is the question. So, you all know the nomenclatures in hexagonal prism. So, totally it will have two faces. This is top face and this is bottom face. This can be called as base. Okay. So, totally 6 rectangular faces are there and 6 base edges there and also 6 top face edges there. Okay. So, these can be called as longer edge. Okay. So, in this problem, we are going to rest this particular hexagonal prism on one of its base edge. So, these 6 base edges are there. We are going to rest in any one of these base edge. Okay. And also, we are going to tilt this prism 40 degree to HP such that its axis will be 40 degree to HP. Okay. So, let us start the diagram. So, first step, draw XY reference line. Okay. Then, it is given that it is resting on HP. So, what will be the simple projection? So, we are going to draw 4 diagrams. So, front view, top view in simple projection and front view, top view in the final position after tilting the prism. Okay. So, what will be the simple projection if this prism is resting on HP. So, as like I said in planes, projection of planes, we have seen lot of diagrams. So, as like that, we are going to draw the simple projection in solid also. So, this is the solid we have taken. If it is resting on HP on its base, so we are going to rotate the solid towards 40 degree to HP. So, before rotation, what will be the position of that particular solid? That will be the simple projection. So, if you want to tilt this particular hexagon to 40 degree to HP such that its axis is 40 degree to HP, we need to keep the hexagon on HP such that it is resting on base. Okay. So, provided if you want to tilt in this direction, so if you want to tilt in this direction, we can keep the resting edge on right side. If you want to tilt the hexagon in left hand direction, so earlier I said was if it is tilting on right side, we can have the resting edge on right side. If you want to tilt the hexagon on left side, we can keep the resting edge on left side. So it is of your comfort. You can draw whichever side you want. So I am keeping in right side. So for that, if a particular hexagon is resting on HP, definitely the true shape of this particular prism, the true shape is hexagon. So, if it is hexagonal prism, the true shape is hexagon. If it is pentagonal prism, the true shape will be pentagon. So, as like plane, if it is resting on HP on one of its base side, if it is base side or base edge, sides and edges are same. So, if it is resting on base, definitely the true shape will get visible on top view. Okay. Whether it is a side or corner. So, usually the base will have 6 sides and 6 corners. Okay. So, these 6 edges and 6 corners. So, if it is resting on HP on its base, or in corner, whatever may be, if it is resting on base in any one of these two nomenclatures, that is base and that is edges and the corners, definitely the true shape of the hexagon will get visible on top view. So that's what I am going to draw. See here, I have drawn the true shape of the hexagonal prism, that is hexagon on top view, that is below XY. Okay, we can leave some space. Since it is resting on HP, it is not touching on VP. Okay, so that's why I have left a space in top view. Okay, so this is two sides I have taken. So these two sides I have taken. So I am going to rest this side, that is the side which I am taken on right side. Okay, if you want, you can rest this edge also. Okay, so let us name these corners. So A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, totally six corners are there. You can name these corners. Then here the A, B, C, D, E, F, these are all the corners which I have, which is present on the top face. Okay, so totally six corners on top face and these six corners on bottom, that is bottom face. Okay, so when you see from top, so when you see from top, the top face corners will be visible. So that's why I have drawn A, B, C, D, E on outside of the hexagon. Okay, similarly the bottom corners, so let us name this as P, Q, R, S, T. So if this is A corner, the respective straight corners can be taken as P. Okay, so in that way I have named P, Q, R, S, T and U. Okay, so these corners which I have mentioned inside the hexagon is the bottom corner, and the name which I have mentioned outside the hexagon is the top corner. Okay, clear? So then we can mark the dimension of the hexagon, that is 30 mm side. So we have to mark by putting extension line and dimension line and 30. So these top view can be drawn using 2H pencil. Clear? So then project all the six corners, that is totally visible six corners and invisible six corners, 12 corners are there. We are going to draw the projection line from all the corners. Okay, so just draw the projection line from F and A. So A and F will be at same line. Similarly B, E, C, D. So the respective bottom corners are P, Q, R, S, T. Okay, so have to draw a projection line from all the corners. Clear? So after this you can draw the front view. Since the front view is a rectangle, so this is the hexagonal prism. So when it is placing on the table, so imagine that the hexagonal prism is resting on HP, that is it is placing over the table. So when you see from here, the front view will be a rectangle. So that is what we are going to draw here. So since it is given that the axis length is 60, we can draw the line for length 60. Okay, let us draw this particular edge, that is AP edge. Okay, AP will be the longer edge. Similarly FU will be the longer edge. So this will be the longer edge. Okay, if this is P, this will be A. So the AP will be longer edge. So let us draw that one. Okay, see here I have drawn the line of 60 mm length. So this length of this particular line will be 60. You have to mention that one. Okay, then let us finish this particular top view. So since it is a rectangle, so there will be a straight line from this point, and also there will be a straight line from this point. So like that, the front view will be like this. Okay, so we can name these corners. So this will be the bottom portion of the prism. So we have named as P, Q, R, S, T, U. So this will be P and U, this will be Q and T, and this will be R and S. Okay, so when you see from here, P will be visible, U will be invisible. Similarly Q is visible, T is invisible, R is visible, S is invisible. So the invisible corners can be marked in bracket. Okay, see here I have marked all the corners. Okay, similarly we can mark the top face corner, that is A, B, C, D, E. So when you see from here, A will be visible, F will be invisible. So likewise you have to mark all the corners on top face. Okay, so this is the simple projection of the hexagonal prism when it is resting on HP on one of its base side. So I am going to rest this side, that is R and S base side, on HP. So let us do that. The second step of the question is the axis is inclined at 40 degree to HP. So we have to rest the RS side, that is edge, and the axis should be tilted to 40 degree to HP. So if the axis is inclined 40 degree to HP, the inclination will be visible on front view. So this is the front view. So we are going to tilt this front view 40 degree to HP. Okay. So before tilting it, you must be very careful that the dimension of this top view should not get changed. We are going to tilt this front view without changing the dimension. Okay. So the length should be 60 and the breadth should be this breadth. Okay. P dash S dash breadth. What is the breadth? Okay. Draw this particular front view, that is rectangle, in such a way that its axis should be 40 degree to HP. Okay. So let us do that. So the what will be the axis in this particular front view? So I already said that the axis is the imaginary line that drawn from the center of the top face and center of the bottom face. Okay. The axis will be present at the middle of the prism. So which means this Q dash B dash, we have drawn Q dash B dash longer edge, similarly R dash, sorry, T dash and E dash longer edge. This axis line will get merged with this longer edge. So this will be the axis line. Okay. So we are going to tilt this particular line 40 degree to HP. So if you are tilting this line, definitely this line will also be tilted to 40. Similarly, this also will be tilted to 40 because these three lines are parallel to each other. So when you incline this line, definitely this line will also get inclined and also this line will also get inclined. So for our comfort, and since I am going to rest RS on XY, that is HP, I am going to tilt this particular line. Okay. So I am going to draw this particular line at first. Okay. Take the protractor, keep anywhere over XY. So I am keeping here, and since it is a 40 degree to HP, I have marked 40 degree inclination. Okay. Then draw the line 40 degree inclined to XY. Clear? So the length of this line should be the length of R dash C dash. Okay. This length and this length should be equal because I have drawn the line R dash C dash. Clear? So I have drawn this longer edge. So it is 40 degree inclined line. So let us name this as R1 dash, S1 dash, C1 dash, B1 dash. Okay. In second position, I have mentioned 1 in the suffix. Okay. So see here, we have rested R1, S1. That is one of the base edge as per the question. Clear? So this is 40. So since it is a 40, definitely axis will be 40. Okay. So then draw this line, that is R dash, P dash, this line, that is the base of this particular front view. So it will be 90 degree to R dash C dash line. So it is 90 degree to R dash C dash line. So you can draw a line 90 degree to this R1 dash C1 dash. Okay. So this length should be equal to this length, that is P dash and R dash. So draw a line perpendicular to R1 dash C1 dash such that the length of this line should be P dash R dash. Okay. So now let us name this as P1 dash and U1 dash. Since here we have named as P dash U dash, in the second position I have named P1 dash U1 dash. Clear? Then draw one parallel line to R dash C dash, that is R1 dash C1 dash. We can draw a parallel line here. That will be the P dash A dash line. Okay. So this length and this length should be equal. Okay. Then you can name this as A1 dash F1 dash, as we have named here as A dash F dash. Okay. So then you can join this to form the complete rectangle that is inclined 40 degree to HP. That is, the axis is inclined at 40 degree to HP. Okay. Then you can draw the axis line, that is Q dash B dash edge, that is longer edge. You can draw such a way that the distance between these two should be equal to these two. Okay. So take a compass or scale. You can measure Q dash R dash distance such that you can mark the distance of Q1 dash T1 dash from R1 dash. Clear? So you can draw the parallel line. So these three lines should be parallel to each other. See here, I have just resembled the same rectangle. The only difference is it is inclined 40 degree to XY, that is HP. So here, if it is, this is 40, definitely this line will be 40 and this line will be 40. So this is the axis line that you can mention. So before that, you can name this as B1 dash and E1 dash. Okay. So now just draw the axis line mentioning that this will be 40 degree. Okay. So in such a way that we have tilted the axis line of this particular prism. Clear? So you can able to see the difference between these two diagrams. So this I have drawn using HB pencil. This can be drawn using 2H pencil. Okay. So you have to follow this procedure, because in solids, pencil handling is very, very important. So try to use 2H pencil for the simple projection and HB pencil for the final projection, and remaining all can be drawn using H pencil. Okay. Now project all the corners of this particular front view. Okay, you have to project P1 dash, Q1 dash, R1 dash, similarly A1 dash, B1 dash and C1 dash. So project all the corners towards a downward. Okay, draw the projection line from these corners. Similarly, there are 6 corners here. So you can draw a projection line from each of this corner towards the right side to meet this particular line. Clear? So here lot of meeting points are there, so we can mark those points. So first, that is P1 dash and P will meet at P1. Okay, this can be named as P1. So you can mark a point here. Similarly, Q and Q meet here. You can mark a point here. Likewise, you can mark all the meeting points like this. Okay, so here I have named all the corners, that is the meeting point of those two corners. Okay, so on either side, A1 dash and A will meet at A1. So likewise, you can mark the point here also. You can name these points as A1, B1, C1. So we have named all the points, meeting points. Okay. So that's all. The next is the final step to draw the final view. So this, you must be very careful while drawing this final portion. So listen carefully. So there are two different lines will be present on the final position, that is final drawing. Okay. So both visible and invisible edges and faces will be there. So we need to draw the visible edge in the continuous straight line and the invisible edges in dotted line. Okay. First let us draw the visible line. For that, you are going to see the hexagon which is inclined from this view. Okay. So when you see from here, the total face, that is the top face of the hexagon, this will be the top face. This total top face will get visible. Okay, that is A, B, C, D, E. So total A, B, C, D, E. This face will get visible completely. So these are all the corners that is present on the top face. So when you join all these corners, we will get 6 edges, that is visible edges. So when you see from here, these total edges will be visible. So I have drawn all the edges in the continuous dark line using HB pencil. Okay. Similarly, when you see from here, the longer edge P1 dash and A1 dash, similarly U1 dash and F1 dash will get visible. Okay. So only these two will be visible when you see from here. So that can be drawn using a continuous dark line. See here, U1 F1, that is U1 dash F1, similarly P1 A1 can be drawn using continuous lines. Okay. So then we have to guess all the remaining edges. For that, we can see the solid from here. Okay. So imagine you are seeing from this way. Okay. When you see from here, the edges FU, AP will be visible. Similarly, ET will be visible. BQ will be visible. PQ will be visible. UP will be visible. UT will be visible. Okay. So When you divide this hexagon, that is top view, into two equal halves, the left side edges will be visible and the right side edges will be invisible. Okay, let us do that. So first FU. So we have already drawn FU seeing from here. So no problem. Then AP will be visible. we have drawn already AP. Okay. Then see here, UT will be visible. UP will be visible. PQ will be visible. So we can draw these three edges in the visible line. Okay. See here. Okay. Then ET will be visible. Similarly, BQ will be visible. So let us draw that also. Okay. Then we can draw the invisible lines. That is TS will be invisible. SR will be invisible. QR will be invisible. So let us draw TS invisible, SR invisible, RQ invisible. Okay. Then SD will be invisible. RC will be invisible. So SD should be invisible. We have already drawn a part line as a visible. That is in SD, there is one more edge, SF is there. So we have already drawn this as visible line. So no need to disturb that. So remaining can be drawn in invisible line, that is dotted line. So we have to draw F1, D1 invisible, similarly A1, C1 invisible. So in RC, part line is already visible, so no need to disturb that. The remaining lines can be drawn in invisible. So that's all. Okay. So this is the final diagram, that is the top view of this hexagonal prism when it is resting on HP, in which if the axis is inclined 40 degree to HP, the projection of the hexagonal prism will be this. So top view and front view. Okay. Now you can write all dimensions are in mm and projection of solids. Otherwise, you can mention projection of hexagonal prism itself. Okay. So here. So this is the final diagram. So be clear that you have used a correct pencil. So these two diagrams should be drawn using 2H pencil. These two diagrams can be drawn in HB pencil. Clear? So that's all. So we will meet in a different solids in next class. Okay. Thank you.